Jai Jinendra. Today we will talk about the fifth characteristic of the soul, which is truthfulness, Uttam Satya. Truthfulness is the opposite of falsehood, right? Now when we think about truthfulness, what it means is that you know the truth, you believe in the truth, and your actions should be truthful. Okay. Now, when does this happen? This happens when one recognizes its own self and recognizes the quality of oneself, and then sees that this falsehood is not my nature. Okay. Remaining in falsehood, meaning being untruthful, always makes you unhappy. And it brings with it all the kashayas, right? Say for instance, in all the kashayas, like one kashay leads to another kashay. For instance, you don't know about the fact that anything in this universe or anything in this world is not permanent. Everything changes, right? Whatever we have is not permanent. It is bound to change. We are bound to lose what we have. It depends on how long we have it. That's not the case. But eventually, we'll definitely lose it, right? So when we understand that truth, then our attachment towards all these worldly things will diminish slowly, slowly, right? The more and more we understand this, the less and less the kashayas will get. Okay, the level of the kashaya will go down. So, how do we know what is the truth? Right? Truth is the nature of the substance. All the substance in this universe, like jiv, udgal, dharma, adharma, akash, kal. These are the six dravyas. Among these six dravyas, five are non-living and only jiv is living. So these four of those, like dharma, adharma, akash and kal, they are just there. They are not affecting us. Okay, we jiv gets affected by pudgal. Okay, how we get attached to our body, we get attached to our family, we get attached to our belongings. And that attachment creates all the kashaya. Now, when we know the truth that all these belongings, including our body, is not with us permanently, we are going to lose it, right? Because it's with us for this lifespan only. Next lifespan, we cannot take anything with us. We see that around us. We see people dying and leaving everything behind, right? Now, this is the truth. This is the fact. Okay, when we think about it and we deeply get deep engrossment in this thinking, then we realize this. We realize the truth. We know the truth, right? When we know the truth and when we believe in it, then that truthfulness comes out from within. Okay, then we will be truthful in our thoughts. We will be truthful in our actions and we will be truthful in our speech also, right? Unless and until we understand the truth, the real truth, we cannot practice truthfulness in our thoughts, in our speech or in our actions. So to do that, we need to study the scriptures, because our Tirthankars have shown us the path to which leads us to self-realization. And this self-realization, meaning knowing who we are, is very important. Okay, so because of that, we will understand our own capabilities, right? You must have seen that in our day-to-day life, whenever somebody lies, okay, to get what they want, or it just becomes a habit to lie without any reason, you know, And lying is taken so lightly that people say, oh, it's okay, he's lying. No, that is not true. When someone lies, and because of their lies, others are getting hurt, and they have to face bad consequences, then those people will not trust the liar person. Liar person loses the respect in the society. Liar person himself will suffer because always will be anxious that what if I get caught, right? And then that anxiousness leads to another lie, because one lie leads to another lie, and this sequence of lies goes on and on and on and on. It doesn't end, okay? And so that person is not living peacefully, and it is hurting. It's hurting them, but we don't realize it. They don't. So what we need to think is that understand the way everything works. Understand why it's happening, whatever is happening around us, right? What is the fact behind it? Understand the true nature of all the dravyas, mainly jiva and pudgal, right? How does it work? How does jiva stays in one life form and goes to another life form? What makes it, what decides of for that jiva, that what kind of life form that jiva will get, the next one or in the future also, right? All that is decided according to the type of karma we bind, right? And those karmas are bound when we have all these kashas and we have all these impurities within us. Now, if we are greedy, if we are egoistic, if we are deceitful, if we are crooked, okay, or if we are untruthful, all those kashas that occurs within us, and we get engrossed in it, and then we are hurting our own self. We don't want to do that, and so this Das Lakshan Parva makes us realize that these kashas are hurting you, and you want to get rid of it to have the permanent peace, to have the permanent happiness. Okay? Those who do that, then they will think truthfully, they will speak truth, and their actions will also be truthful. Meaning their life will be so simple and straightforward, right? And they will get respect also in the society. Other peoples will believe in them. And so the worldly life will be also peaceful, and the future lives also will be good life because of the punya that is bound because of the truthfulness, right? Truthfulness, there are so many examples in the scriptures that those who are lying or those who doesn't know the facts of life are miserable, and they go through lots of misery. And those who understand the truth and those who practice the truthfulness, eventually they are the most happiest person, right? So that's why the truth, Uttam Satya, is very important, and we all need to work on it. We all need to be aware all the time that the falsehood does not take over. Okay, we are the one who can correct us. We are the one, everybody can correct their own self, right? So we have to be aware and we have to be alert that I will not sway away in this lies or in this attachment that makes me go into falsehood, right? And so we all need to concentrate on this quality of us, and we will bring it out. Okay, so this is why this day, Uttam Satya, is very important. I think that's about it. Anything else? See, this is this just 10, 12 minutes is not enough. I'm sorry, but it's not enough to go into such a detailed subject, right? So we need a little bit more time and a little bit more study about it to understand it. And I hope you all will be encouraged by this introduction, and you all will concentrate on getting more information and study more about it. Okay? Jai Jinendra.